Dengue fever is an endemic disease common in over 140 countries in the world. It is caused by dengue virus, which can be categorized into five main types. Dengue viruses are viruses that use mosquitoes as vectors to infect humans who are the hosts. Currently, the only vaccine approved for dengue is Dengvaxia. However, there is a problem with Dengvaxia. It can only be given to individuals who have already been infected with dengue before. These individuals are called seropositive. Seropositive is a word that combines serum and positive. Serum means blood and positive means that antibodies can be detected. Hence, a dengue seropositive individual is someone with detectable antibodies against dengue in its blood. In contrast, seronegative individuals vaccinated with Dengvaxia may have an increased risk of getting severe disease if infected with dengue. Why is this the case? To understand that, you must first understand the concept of antibody-dependent enhancement. Normally, when a person is infected with a pathogen, antibodies against the pathogen will be produced in the body, which protects the body against future infections. In the case of dengue virus, a dengue-infected individual will produce antibodies against only the type of dengue virus that is causing the infection, but not against the other types of dengue viruses. In addition, most of the antibodies produced have high potential for antibody-dependent enhancement. For now, these antibodies act as guards against the first type of dengue virus. However, when a secondary infection with another type of dengue virus occurs, instead of fighting the dengue viruses, these antibodies recognize part of the dengue virus, but couldn't relate it to the fact that these viruses are actually relatives to the first type of dengue virus. Due to their recognition of that one part, the antibodies are confused into mistakenly letting these new viruses into the cells. Due to the high viral entry, a more severe disease occurs, which is why secondary dengue infections are more dangerous. This is called the antibody-dependent enhancement. When it comes to the vaccine Dengvaxia, it targets the four main types of dengue virus but with different levels of efficacy. As a result, vaccination with Dengvaxia is equivalent to a primary infection without the disease, unless for some side effects. Therefore, when a vaccinated person is then infected with a type of dengue virus that the body is less protected against, a severe dengue disease may occur due to the pre-existing antibodies against other types of dengue virus, according to the antibody-dependent enhancement concept. In general, a non-vaccinated seronegative individual, which is someone who has never been infected with dengue or vaccinated before, may get a mild disease when infected, or might never become infected with dengue in their lifetime. A non-vaccinated seropositive individual, which is someone who has been infected with dengue but has not been vaccinated before, will already have a mild disease during primary infection. Similarly, a vaccinated seronegative individual, which is someone who has never been infected with dengue but has been vaccinated before, is equivalent to having already had their first mild infection. Therefore, when these two individuals are infected with another type of dengue virus during secondary infection, they have the same amount of risk for a severe disease, due to antibody-dependent enhancement. On the other hand, a vaccinated seropositive individual, which is someone who has been infected with dengue and vaccinated, will already have their first mild infection, plus protection against secondary infection. Therefore, when this individual is infected with another type of dengue virus during secondary infection, no disease or only a mild disease will occur. Even if the protection of Dengvaxia is incomplete towards all types of dengue viruses, a vaccinated seropositive individual has no added risk to a severe secondary disease, only reduced risk. This is why Dengvaxia is intended only for this group of individuals. What about the other groups of individuals? Many dengue vaccines with enhanced technologies are currently under research, and we hope that they will soon prove to be available and effective for all. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, or subscribe. If you would like to learn more, check out these videos.